So the telomere talk continues. I cannot express enough to you to go out and read The Telomere Effect by Elizabeth Blackburn and Elise Epel. You must read it. It's easy to understand. All right, so how do we develop a challenge response to stress? Okay, so our brains are wired to predict, and it's because we remember. We used past experiences to build our lives upon. If we grew up in a loving family, our view of the world is going to be quite different than if we grew up in a volatile situation. Still, we can rewrite our responses. So the book cites an example. A runner knows she doesn't run well because of the stress to do well right before the race. She wants to stop the effects. The doctor asks her why. Instead of trying to stop the racing heart, why not use it? I love this, and I'm going to quote it. Instead of trying to make the butterflies in my stomach go away, I need to make those butterflies line up and fly in formation. That's your thought for today. How are you going to make those butterflies fly in formation? Until tomorrow, have a great day. Okay, but some of us aren't runners, and some of us are experiencing something besides short-term stress. Some of us are in a marathon of stress. So how about this? My body's responses are trying to help me. They are working to help me focus on the task at hand. That is a sign that I care. This mindset will go a long way to helping us change our responses, but they can be overdone. And even if we are successful with this change of outlook, we still need rest and relaxation. Things like meditation, chanting, or other mindful practices all stimulate our telomeres and maybe the growth of our telomeres. I've talked some about presence from other books, and I've read and watched videos that talk about presence and mindfulness. The ability to stay in the moment gives us a certain freedom from chronically stressful situations. Stress does not have to live in each little moment, and we do have a choice about how we spend this moment. When we worry about events that haven't happened yet, we're letting stress overflow its time boundary. Have you heard the saying, letting tomorrow's worry steal today's peace? So today's thought is stay in the moment. Don't let tomorrow's troubles take your peace for today. Stay where you are. Have a great day. Raise your hand if you have ever finished a huge project and then caught one heck of a cold. I know I have. Most of the time it's right after the last musical performance. I'm up. All of those challenge responses to stress driving me hard. But then when it's over, the stress suppressed the immune system, and half the time I'm sick at Thanksgiving. So how does stress living in the mind damage the immune system? Telomeres. Short telomeres means premature aging of the immune system, which means worsening immune functioning. Do you remember studying T cells in science class? You know, the ones that fight infections? They have telomeres too, and they can become short just like the other cells' telomeres. Guess what happens when they do? We become ripe for criminal infestation of virus, bacteria, or cancerous cells because the T cells can no longer perform their duties of ridding our bodies of the invaders. So, challenge responses are great, but we have to live in moderation with mindfulness as well. Sound like a repeat? See you tomorrow. So, it seems that the fighters in our immune system are especially vulnerable to stress. The telomeres get short, they can't fight properly, the worn down fighters send out protein molecules that create systemic inflammation. They refuse to die, and they accumulate in our blood. These bad apples spread their inflammatory goop, their bad cells, like a slow drip. And over time, with too many in our bloodstream, we can develop some or all of the diseases of inflammation. Heart, joints, bones, nerves, even our gums. When these cells grow old, we do too, no matter what age we are. Have I mentioned this book is amazing? I'm about to get to the part that tells us how to protect our telomeres even more. So in the meantime, for today's homework, think about that stress that you're going through and think about the age of your cells and how we can change that so that you don't develop these diseases. Have a great day. How about a recap for the week? First, telomeres don't sweat the small stuff. Toxic stress? Now that's the culprit. Short telomeres create sluggish immune function. Short telomeres promote inflammation, and inflammation leads to degenerative tissues and diseases of aging. We cannot rid our lives of stress. Not if we live, love, and care for others. But we can approach stressful events with a challenge mentality rather than fear. We can also promote healthy living with a clean diet, relaxation techniques, developing a mindfulness for the moments we're in. And because my religious beliefs bring this all into focus for me, I will be the first to promote developing a belief in something higher than yourself. Prayer, reading the Bible, studying the Word, that helps me with whatever stress is in my life. Try it, and we'll continue next week. Have a great weekend.